Good morning, Michael here, and today we conclude our look at Psalms 4 as we focus on verse 8 for the exposition. Let's then go ahead and look at the psalm in totality before getting to that exposition. And it's subtitled, Answer Me When I Call. Verse 1. Answer me when I call, O God of my righteousness. You have given me relief when I was in distress. Be gracious to me and hear my prayer. O men, how long shall my honor be turned into shame? How long will you love vain words and seek after lies? Selah. But know that the Lord has set apart the godly for himself. The Lord hears when I call to him. Be angry and do not sin. Ponder in your own hearts, on your beds, and be silent. Selah. Offer right sacrifices and put your trust in the Lord. There are many who say, Who will show us some good? Lift up the light of your face upon us, O Lord. You have put more joy in my heart than they have when their grain and wine abound. Verse 8. In peace I will both lie down and sleep. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety. And we turn to the treasury of David. For the exposition, verse 8, Sweet evening hymn. I shall not sit up to watch through fear, but I will lie down. And then I will not lie awake listening to every rustling sound, but I will lie down in peace and sleep. For I have naught to fear. He that hath the wings of God above him needs no other curtain. Better than bolts or bars is the protection of the Lord. Armed men kept the bed of Solomon, but we do not believe that he slept more soundly than his father, whose bed was the hard ground, and who was haunted by bloodthirsty foes. Note the word only, which means that God alone was his keeper, and that though alone, without man's help, he was even then in good keeping, where he was alone with God. A quiet conscience is a good bedfellow. How many of our sleepless hours might be traced to our untrusting and disordered minds? They slumber sweetly, whose faith rocks to sleep. No pillow so soft as a promise, no coverlet so warm as an assured interest in Christ. O Lord, give us this calm repose on Thee, that like David we may lie down in peace and sleep each night while we live, and joyfully may we lie down in the appointed season to sleep in death, to rest in God. Dr. Hawker's reflection upon this psalm is worthy to be prayed over and fed upon with sacred delight. We cannot help transcribing it. Reader, let us never lose sight of the Lord Jesus while reading this psalm. He is the Lord, our righteousness, and therefore, in all our approaches to the mercy seat, let us go there in a language corresponding to this, which calls Jesus the Lord, our righteousness. While men of the world, from the world, are seeking their chief good, let us desire his favor, which infinitely transcends corn and wine, and all the good things which perish in the using. Yes, Lord, thy favor is better than life itself. Thou causest them that love thee to inherit substance, and filleth all their treasure. O thou gracious God and Father, hast thou in such a wonderful manner set apart one in our nature for thyself? Hast thou indeed chosen one out of the people? Hast thou beheld him in the purity of his nature, as one in every point godly? Hast thou given him as the covenant of the people, and hast thou declared thyself well pleased in him? O then, well may my soul be well pleased in him also. Now do I know that my God and Father will hear me when I call upon him in Jesus' name. And when I look up to him for acceptance, for Jesus' sake, yes, my heart is fixed, O Lord. My heart is fixed. Jesus is my hope and righteousness. The Lord will hear me when I call, and henceforth will I both lay me down in peace and sleep securely in Jesus, accepted in the Beloved. For this is the rest wherewith the Lord causeth the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing. Yes, indeed. What a beautiful psalm, as you see the light of it, even in the exposition. Answer me when I call, O Lord. Great is our God. Trust you enjoyed the meditation. Michael here yet again declaring, Jesus is Lord. Until next time, be blessed.